Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the binary search process. To handle this process, we have to follow these 6 steps. First, we have to make sure that the array is already sorted. And then we have to make sure that the low index is always smaller than or equal to the high index, which will be shown later. Third, we have to evaluate the middle index, which is based on the low index and the high index. And then we check if the middle element coming from this middle index is equal to the target. Four, if the element is on the first half of the array, we just handle the first half and update the high index. On the other hand, if the element is on the second half, we just handle the second half of the array and then we update the low index. And then we just continue steps 2 to 5 until we really find the target, which is equal to the middle element obtained by the middle index, or until the low index is larger than the high index, which is insensible. In this case, we just mean that the target cannot be found from the array. Now, let me show you the way to calculate the 3 indices. The first one is the mid index, which is equal to the low index plus the high index, and then I take the sum, and then I do the integer division by 2. So that's why I have 2 slashes to indicate the integer division. And then if we really need to remain the left-hand part, we just keep the low index unchanged. And then we change the high index by subtracting 1 from the mid index. On the other hand, if the right part is retained, we just update the low index by mid plus 1. And we keep the high index unchanged. So let us see an example. Suppose I want to search target number 3 from these sorted numbers. Now I have 9 numbers and their indices are shown. The first step is to indicate the low index and the high index. The low index is just on the far left hand side of the array, while the high index is on the far right hand side of the array. Since now we have the low index, which is 0, and high index, which is 8, these 2 numbers satisfy low is smaller than or equal to the high index. And then in this case, we can calculate the mid index, which is equal to low plus high, and then I take the integer division by 2. So now, mid is equal to number 4. After we have handled the indices, we can try to find out the middle element indicated by the mid index. So we see that the mid index is 4 and the value corresponding to this index is 15. And now we see that the target is smaller than that number. It means that we just handle the first half and ignore the right hand part. After we have determined to handle the left hand part, we can update the high index, which is equal to mid minus 1. So you see that high becomes number 3 right now. It is no longer number 8 as before. And now we have the first half to be handled, and the right-hand part can be ignored. Since we have low index which is equal to or smaller than the high index, we can find the mid index which is equal to low plus high, and then I take the integer division by 2. So now we see that mid is equal to 3 divided by 2 according to integer division, which returns 1. So the mid index becomes 1. And then I check the value corresponding to the mid index. Now we see that value's mid becomes 3. And now we see that the target is equal to the value corresponding to the mid index. In this case, we say that the target is found at index 1, and the search is now done. Let us see another example. Suppose I want to find out 19 from these sorted numbers. And of course, I've already provided the indices of these values. The first step is to indicate the low index and the high index. Low is for the far left element, and high is for the far right element. So low is 0 and high is 8 for now. Since we have low index which is more than or equal to the high index, we can calculate the mid index, which is equal to low plus high, and then I take the integer division by 2. So we have mid equals 4. and we check that the mid-index corresponds to a value of 15. And now we have the target number, which is 19, that is larger than the value corresponding to the mid-index. So in this case, we just handle the second half of the array. And we can update the low index, which is equal to mid plus 1. So mid is 4, and low is just 4 plus 1, which gives me 5. And now we just handle the right-hand part and ignore the left-hand part. Now, since the low index is smaller than or equal to the high index, I can find out the mid index as low plus high divided by 2 using integer division. And now we have mid equals 8 plus 5, and then I divide the sum by 2 using integer division, so I have 6. Now we have the value corresponding to the mid index equal to 20, but the target is 19. So we have the condition that the target is smaller than the value corresponding to the mid-index. In this case, we take the first half of the remaining array. In this case, we can just handle the high index, which is equal to mid minus 1. So mid is now 6, 6 minus 1 is 5. So we can see that both low and high are located at index number 5. Since both high and low indices are the same, we can find out the mid value, which is equal to low plus high divided by 2 using integer division. So I can see that mid is equal to 5 plus 5 divided by 2 using integer division, which is 5 as the answer. So you can see that all three indices are located together at index 5. And then we pick up the value corresponding to the middle index. Now we have 17. But we see that the target is larger than that value corresponding to the mid-index. In this case, we handle the second half of the remaining portion of the array. And then I update the low index to mid plus 1. So we see that low is now number 6, because mid is 5, and 5 plus 1 is 6. But we can see that in this case, the low index is larger than the high index. In this case, we can say that the search is unsuccessful. That means the target cannot be found from the array. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.